Ever heard of Newton's laws? It goes like this. The laws of motion became the laws of the universe. Well, that's physics, my friends.
You know, movement is such a huge part of our lives. I mean, we see and we do things every day.
Ever wonder how something not moving at all can suddenly go flying through the air? Well, that's physics. Remember riding those bumper cars at the beach? Now, what happens when your buddy smashes into you? How about those Olympic weightlifters? What does it take for them to move the bar up and down? Well, that's all physics.
Newton created three laws of motion to help us understand why and how objects move. Let's see how this really works in our lives.
The first law says that an object at rest will stay that way unless something forceful moves it. Otherwise, it stays on its course. Let's look at it both ways. Ooh, swing and a miss. But the ball continues on its course into the glove. Contact! The ball flies into the air. That's baseball, kids. And it's also physics. Law number two is all about acceleration. Objects will move harder and faster when something pushes it. I mean, who doesn't walk and text at the same time? Come on. It's not a smart move, but it is physics. Now for law three. When an object is pushed in one direction, there is always a resistance of the same size in the opposite direction. Hey, music is great, but it is also a great distraction.
Here's a two-part experiment that lets us see how motion and reaction time really work. What are the physical factors that can make an object in motion stop dead in its tracks?
For part one, let's grab our NYSD Science Kit. We'll need the modeling clay, vinyl baseboard material, one green toy car, and five or six textbooks. Now, let's set up the ramp for rolling the car.
Make sure that your ramp is 8 inches high.
So it's 20 centimeters, in case you wonder.
Okay, take the ramp material and roll it out over the books and onto the table. Make sure that you tuck the edges of the ramp material into the books to secure the ramp. Hey, let's make a clay figure that'll drive the car. Your kids can be as creative as they want with this.
Okay, oh, it's a whole family. All right, cool.
At the bottom of the ramp, there will be a book or heavy object. This is what the car is going to crash into. Here we go. Now let's place the car at the top of the ramp and hold on. Ready? Let it go. What has happened to the clay figure and to the car? Tell me what you guys just saw. Did the car travel after the crash? If it did, how far did it go? Did the obstacle move?
And what's the distance our clay guy traveled after the crash? Do the physical factors affect the car's ability to stop? Was speed a factor? Before we make any assumptions, let's replace the textbook with the tissue box. Now we're gonna do the same exact steps to start.
So let's go ahead and take our car and bring it up to the top of our ramp. All right, go ahead and drop it.
How was the outcome different than our first car crash?
Did the physical factors influence the car's ability to stop? Was speed a factor? What happened to the driver? What is the difference between the car hitting the textbook or the tissue box?
What might have happened to a person in both these car crash examples? Come on, kids. Let's see how we play a role in physics, too. In part two of our experiment, we're going to explore your reaction time and how that affects bodies in motion.
Let's collect our materials. We need the NYSD Science Kit again. Grab the ruler from it. But what's not in it? Your cell phones or calculators.
We need two groups. So who wants to be my human guinea pigs? We need a dropper and a grabber. Don't worry, everyone's going to get a turn.
The dropper must hold the end of the ruler between the thumb and forefinger. Here we go. Good. All right, so what mark are you at?
17.
Awesome. Okay, so now we're going to do it with this comically large calculator. So we're going to show how distractions are going to affect your reaction time. So you're going to go ahead and hold that in your left hand. Okay, and you're going to type 787 with your left hand as many times as you can while trying to catch that ruler. Yep, see, that's what I thought.
This part of the experiment is all about reaction time and how it slows down when you're distracted by something else, like, let's say, a calculator. So let's tie this all together now. So think back to part one. We focus on a car in motion. Now, after part two, we have a better understanding of reaction time. These same principles apply not just to the experiment, but all around us. Imagine walking, driving, or catching that baseball. If you're distracted, you won't be able to stop your car or catch that baseball in time.
Now, I'm sure you can name a bunch of examples where distractions affect your role in the physics of everyday life. And sometimes, it can be really dangerous. Let's call out a few of them.
Texting and driving.
Texting while you're walking.
Putting on makeup and driving.
Listening to music while you walk.
And talking to your friend while you're biking.
Yeah. Now that you guys understand the physics of motion and reaction time, you can actually play a role in your community by being aware of distractions and keeping everyone safe.